Welcome friends, in this lecture we will discuss about solution of assignment of week 2 and the name of the week is broadband impedance matching. The name of subject is microwave integrated circuit that is conducted by NPTEL. So we will see the MCQ related with assignment 2 of week 2. So let's start. Calculate the percentage bandwidth of quarter wave transformer. So we have to find the quarter wave transformer percentage bandwidth. The impedance is given 100 ohm, that is equal to load impedance, and 25 ohm is given as a line impedance, that is equal to characteristic impedance, and minimum allowable reflection coefficient is 0.04, that is equal to TM. Okay, so now we have the equation of bandwidth for quarter wave transformer is 2 minus 4 upon pi multiplied by theta M. This is the equation of fractional bandwidth or percentage bandwidth. Now, what is the value of theta m? So, theta m can be calculated from the cos theta m. And the equation of cos theta m is Tm upon square root of 1 minus Tm square multiplied by 2 square root of Z1 divided by RL divided by mod of RL minus Z1. Okay. So, the value of Tm is given to you 0.04. ZL is equal to RL is given to you 100 ohm. And the Z1 is equal to Z2 square by ZL for the quarter wave transformer. That is equal to input impedance. So if you calculate, you will find the value 6.25. Now put all this value in this equation. So you will get theta m is equal to 77.6 in degree. Okay. And now put this value of theta m into this bandwidth equation and consider this pi as a 180. Okay. So you will get the bandwidth is equal to 27%. So the answer is A, 27.3%. So this is the fractional bandwidth of the quarter wave transformer. Okay. Next, which type of taper line would provide minimum reflection coefficient over the passband? So these are the four transformation matrix, or we can say that it is the transformer Chebyshev, Klopfenstein, triangle and linear. Out of this transformer, only Klopfenstein transformer have characteristics that it has minimum attenuation over the pass band, minimum attenuation, or we can say minimum reflection coefficient. So the answer is B, Klopfenstein transformer or taper have minimum reflection coefficient over the pass band. Okay, next, the first tunnel of reflection coefficient, that is T in is equal to 0 for triangle taper, occurs at the beta L equals to, so what? So for triangle taper, the first tunnel occurs at beta L is equal to 2 pi. Okay, as if you refer the theory of triangle taper, then from the origin you will see that the first null occurs at the origin, and that at that value beta L is equal to 2 pi. So the answer is D. Okay, next, the bandwidth of network increases if the number of matching section increase. Either the statement is true or false. So if you have number of stages of networks, and if the number of network is increases, then definitely there will be very less attenuation, and the matching is very high. So matching section if increase, so if the section is increased, the bandwidth is definitely increased, because it is known as the multi-section transformer. And the characteristics of multi-section transformer is that as the number of section increases, the bandwidth increase. So the given statement is true. So the answer is A. Now next is, a quarter wave transformer is terminated by load of 2 ohm that is equal to normalized impedance. What is the normalized input impedance if the quarter wave transformer is given to you? So if the quarter wave transformer is given to you and you have given a load is equal to 2 ohm, then the normalized input impedance, that is equal to Z0 square by ZL. So if you have the value of Z0, that is equal to 1, then 1 divided by 2, that will give you 1 by 2. So the answer is C. Okay. So the normalized input impedance of quarter wave transformer is C is equal to 1 by 2. Okay. Next. This is again the true false statement. Can we say theoretically if an infinite line is perfectly matched? Yes, we can say that infinite line is always perfectly matched. Okay, maximum power transfer from input to output if the line is infinite. So the given statement is true. So the answer is yes. Next is, the Chebyshev transformer has lesser bandwidth as compared to binomial transfer. Whether the statement is true or false. So if you refer the section, then binomial transformer has very less bandwidth as compared to Chebyshev. That means Chebyshev transformer has higher bandwidth compared to binomial transformer. So the given statement is again true. Okay, so answer is A, Next, the reason for using multi-section transformer or multi-section of transmission line as impedance transformer is that why the multi-section transformer is used. Okay, so as I have discussed in previous MCQ, the multi-section, as the number of section increases, then the bandwidth is increased, or we can say that bandwidth is improving. Okay, this is the only reason why we use multi-section transformer. So that is satisfied by this option 2. Okay, so the answer is 2. That means B. Okay, so we are using multi-section of transmission line as impedance transformer because of the to improve the higher bandwidth, or we can say that to increase the bandwidth or to improve the fractional bandwidth. So the answer is B. Okay, next, reflection coefficient in case of quarter wave transformer have nulls at only which frequency? So if you observe the theory of reflection coefficient for quarter wave transformer, then at the origin there are the odd harmonics are very much concentrated. Okay, so at nulls odd harmonics are only present, and at a very high frequency even and odd harmonics both are present in mixture form. So at nulls we have only odd harmonics. So the answer is D. Okay, next, quarter wave transformer is used to match which type of impedance? So generally quarter wave transformer is used to match load impedance, but the load must be in the real form, not in the complex form or imaginary form. It is must be in the real form. And line impedance, that is input impedance, we can say that it can be real or imaginary or complex number. That means quarter wave transformer is used to match only real load impedance and any line impedance. So that is satisfied by equation, or we can say the option B. So real load impedance to any line impedance. So this quarter wave transformer input impedance is always real, and output impedance may be any, real, imaginary or complex. So real load impedance to any line impedance. So answer is B. Okay, next, maximum power is delivered when the load is matched to the line and the power loss in the field line is minimized. So there are the two statements. We have to determine which one is the true. The second statement is impedance matching in a power distribution line will increase the amplitude and phase errors. Okay, so generally impedance matching generally decrease the amplitude and phase error. Okay, so definitely second statement is wrong. So first statement is correct, because maximum power delivered when the load is matched to the line and the power loss in the field is minimized. Because we know the maximum power transfer theorem, maximum power can be delivered from source to load when the line is perfectly matched. So ZL is equal to ZO. So only statement 1 is right, because in statement 2, impedance matching will increase amplitude, but it reduce the error. Okay, but here it is increasing the phase error. It is indicating that it increase the amplitude as well as phase error. So it will increase amplitude, that is right, but phase error is reduced. So statement 2 is wrong and statement 1 is right. So answer is A. Okay, next, 200 load is needed to match with the 100 ohm impedance source. So 200 load is the ZL or RL load impedance, and 100 ohm impedance, that is equal to Z in, and quarter wave transformer is given. What is the value of characteristic impedance? So for quarter wave transformer is also known as lambda by 4 transformer, and for lambda by 4 transformer, the equation of input impedance Z in is equal to ZO square by ZL. Okay, so now you have given ZL, you have given Z in, you have to find out the value of ZO. So ZO is equal to square root of ZL multiplied by Zin. So if you calculate, you will get 141.42. So the answer is B. Okay, next, this is again true false statement. Impedance matching in a power distribution network will increase amplitude error, amplitude and decrease any phase errors. So always, I have told in the previous MCQ that impedance matching will increase the amplitude and decrease the phase error. Okay, but here both are increasing. Okay, so statement is false. So the answer is B. Okay, next, a two section binomial transformer is given, and it is used to match 50 ohm load to the 100 ohm line. So the 50 ohm is given as a load impedance, and 100 ohm line, that is equal to ZO. What is the percentage fractional bandwidth that can be obtained if tau m, that is equal to maximum allowable reflection, is equal to 0.05. So two section is given, that is n is equal to 2. The load is given as 50 ohm, so Z is equal to 50 ohm, and ZO is given as 100 ohm, okay, and PM is equal to 0.05. So the fractional bandwidth, equation of the fractional bandwidth for binomial transformer is 2 minus 4 upon 5 multiplied by theta m, where theta m is equal to angle which is equal to cos inverse 1 upon n in bracket tm divided by mod a raised to 1 upon n. So now n is given to you, that is equal to number of section, that is equal to 2. Tm is also given 0.05, but a is not given. So the equation of a is equal to 1 upon 2 raised to n plus 1 ln zl by zo. So if you put n equal to 2, zl is equal to 50, zo is equal to 100, you will get minus 0.087 as a. Okay, so the now a value you have. So put all the value of zl, zo, tm, n, and a in this equation, you will get fractional bandwidth that is equal to approximately 50%, that is equal to 49.6. So the answer is C. Okay, so this is the equation of fractional bandwidth. Okay, next, two section Chebyshev transformer is given and load impedance is given, ZL is equal to 100 ohm and ZO is equal to characteristic impedance, that is equal to 50 ohm. Calculate the fractional bandwidth and maximum allowable reflection is given, tau m is equal to 0.05. So now the as per the data, you have given value of n equal to 2, tm is equal to 0.05, zl is equal to 100, zo is equal to 50. So for fractional bandwidth for the Chebyshev transformer is 2 minus 4 upon 5 multiplied by theta m, where theta m can be calculated from sec theta m. So sec theta m is equal to cos hyperbolic 1 upon n cos hyperbolic inverse ln zl upon zo divided by 2 tm. Okay, so this is the entire equation of the sec theta m, okay, from which you can calculate theta m. So now n is given to you, n is equal to 2 because it is two section transformer is given, zl is given 100 ohm, zo is given 50 ohm, tm is given 0.05. if you put all this value in this, you will get sec theta m is equal to 1.99, that is approximately equal to 2, and from that theta m is equal to sec inverse 1.99, that is equal to 59.86. so if you put this theta m in this equation, 2 minus 4 upon 5 theta m, okay, so theta m is equal to 59.86 and take 5 is equal to 180, you will get the value 67%, that is equal to answer B. So fractional bandwidth is 67%. Okay, next, to minimize the mismatch in exponential taper, the length beta l of the line has to be greater than what? So in exponential taper, beta l is always greater than equal to lambda by 2. Beta l is always greater than 2 pi. So if you put the beta is equal to 2 pi by lambda, so you will get beta l is always greater than lambda by 2. So the answer is B. Okay. Next, to minimize the mismatch in triangle taper, the length of the beta l of the line has to be greater than what? For triangle taper, beta l is always greater than pi. So if you put beta is equal to 2 pi by lambda, you will get beta l is always greater than equal to lambda. Okay, so for exponential taper, beta l must be greater than lambda by 2, and for triangle taper, beta l must be greater than lambda. Okay, next, exponential taper is given to you, z of z is equal to z0 e raised to az for z between 0 to l is used to match 100 ohm load. So zl is given 100 ohm and 50 ohm is given as z0. okay, what is the value of l and a to satisfy tm is equal to 0.05? okay, so now tm is also given and we have to find the value of l and a. So this is all the answer. First answer is capital L, length of the exponential taper, and the second answer is A. For exponential taper, the value of A can be calculated from this equation. A is equal to 1 upon L ln ZL by ZO. So put the value of ZL. ZL is equal to 100 ohm. ZO is equal to 50 ohm. And L remain as it is. And TM is equal to 0.05. Here TM is not much of a concern because it is not needed in this equation. So you will get A is equal to 0.693 divided by L. Okay, from this equation, put the value of ZL and ZO, you will get this equation, A and L, relating A and L. Now, this is the value of L. First take A, this is the value of L. So put this value of L in this equation. Okay, so you will not get this answer. Okay, so that definitely A is not the answer. For B, this is the value of L. Okay, put this value of L in this equation. The answer is not this type in this range. So this is also not answer. But if you put the value of L in this equation, definitely again you will not get this value of A. But if you put L is equal to 0.4353 over here, put the value of L as 0.4353 lambda, you will get A is equal to 1.593 divided by lambda. So the answer is D, 0.4353 L lambda, that is equal to L, and A is equal to 1.593 divided by lambda. Okay, so this is the end of solution. So that's all from my side. So I have covered almost all type of example of week 2 solution. In next lecture, we will discuss about week 3 solution. So I hope this information in this video can be beneficial to you for the current NPTEL session as well as upcoming NPTEL session. So thank you very much.